This video is going to be about adding and subtracting radicals. So let's start with a real basic example. Over here we have 2 times the square root of 5 plus 4 times the square root of 5. Now, the radicands, the numbers underneath the radical signs, are the same. When that happens, all you have to do is add the numbers that are multiplying those radicals. So in other words, we're going to have 2 plus 4, which is 6, times the square root of 5. And if you think about it, it kind of makes sense. We have 2 of these radicals, and then we have 4 of these radicals. So if we have 2 and 4 of them, we end up with 6 altogether. Now, the next one's a little bit harder, and it's going to take some work. So I have the square root of 12 plus the square root of 75. The radicands aren't the same, so it looks like I can't do anything. But if we simplify each of these radicals, then we may find that we can get something out of it. So let's see. 12 is 4 times 3. So I'm going to rewrite this as the square root of 4 times 3. And 4 is a perfect square. And 75 is 25 times 3, and 25 is a perfect square. So I'll rewrite that one also. Now I can pull out the perfect squares from both of these. So the square root of 4 is 2. That means I have 2 times the square root of 3. And taking the square root of 25, which is 5, I have 5 times the square root of 3. Now that my radicands are both the same, I can add these two together pretty easily. So I've got 2 plus 5 is 7. So it's going to be 7 times the square root of 3. So the basic trick here is if your radicands are different, see if you can simplify the expression, see if you can simplify the radical, and perhaps the radicands will end up being the same after all. And then you can add or subtract them. So let's look at another one. Okay, we have 3 times the square root of 45 minus 2 times the square root of 80. And once again, the radicands are different. So I've got to see if I can simplify each one of these. So let's go. We have 3 times the square root and 45, looking for a perfect square that I can divide into 45. I'll use 9. So 45 is the same as 9 times 5. Then I've got minus 2, my radical sign, and I need a perfect square that I can divide into 80. And the biggest square I can find would be 16. So I'm going to have 16 times 5 over here. Now taking this first expression and pulling out the square root of 9, I'm going to have 3, that's the first 3 that I have, times 3 from the square root of 9, times the square root of 5, minus 2, whoops, not yet, times the square root of 16 is 4, so 2 times 4, and I've still got the square root of 5 left. I'll do the multiplication for each of these. So 3 times 3 is 9, times the square root of 5, minus 2 times 4 is 8, times the square root of 5. And now it's just a matter of 9 minus 8 is 1, times the square root of 5. And of course, I don't really need that 1. So I can just rewrite this as the square root of 5. Okay, so once again, the same procedure. The radicands were different. I simplified each of the radicands so that I ended up with similar radicands in both parts of my problem. And then from there, I just got down to the basic answer. Okay, I think we have time for one more. This one looks a little more complicated, but it's basically the same principle. So I've got 6 times the square root of 28 plus the square root of 63, and all of that's over 10. So let's start with dealing with the radicals first. I'm going to have 6. I want to simplify this square root of 28, and I can divide it by 4. So this will become the square root of 4 times 7. And 63, I can divide a 9 into 63, so that will be the square root of 9 times 7. And that's all over 10. Okay, let's take the square roots out of this. So I have 6 times the square root of 4 is 2. So 6 times 2 times the square root of 7 plus square root of 9 is 3. 3 times the square root of 7 over 10. I'll do the multiplication here. So 6 times 2 is 12 times the square root of 7 plus 3 times the square root of 7 over 10. And let's see, 12 plus 3 is 15. So I have 15 times the square root of 7 over 10. And I can simplify this 15 over 10. I can divide them both by 5. So that's going to give me 3. 15 divided by 5 is 3, times the square root of 7. And the 10 divided by 5 is 2. So that's going to be my answer. 3 times the square root of 7 over 2. And once again, the principle was the same for this one as it was for the other ones. Since we don't have the same radicands, we simplify each of the radicals. And if we then end up with radicands that are similar, as I did here, we can combine them either by adding or subtracting, whatever the problem calls for. And since this was also a fraction, we had to take care of the division part of it. So we just reduce this 15 tenths into 3 halves. And that's going to be my answer. Okay, so that's basically how it works. Get a lot of practice with these and they should be no problem. Take care. I'll see you next time.